Hi, I'm Julian Ray, and I'm here with Michael Ray. Hopefully you all are doing well out there. This is kind of an interesting interview because I've interviewed many people before and from different walks of life. And this is my first time actually interviewing my son. Yeah, we talk and we hung out, 17 years? Since you were zero?
Yeah.
So first time interviewing him, so this is going to be cool. Some questions I'm going to be asking, my first time even asking it. He doesn't know what I'm going to be asking, actually. So Michael. We're in the studio, and you feel right at home. We got some instruments here that you do play as well, and I've seen you just go from not playing many instruments to playing many instruments. What happened, and when was your first say, you know what, I'm going to pick this instrument and some instruments up? And kind of tell us what you play as well.
To start off, I play the electric bass, I play piano, I play most of the percussion as I was trained at my high school. But going into band, I actually didn't want to join band or part of music in general. it was a captain at the time who actually, you know, took me from outside because, you know, they need more people in the band. Mm-hmm. And she actually took me inside and played me a little piece. And, you know, I saw that she was really putting forth the effort, and I was like, you know, maybe this is for me.
Yeah.
So I was like, why not? And I just gave it a shot.
Why not do it?
Yeah, so I ended up making the mallet line, which is like, you know, marimba, xylophone, glockenspiel vibes. I ended up making the mallet line my first
year. I said it on a glockenspiel.
Glockenspiel, yeah.
Glockenspiel. I call it bells, but it's not that. It's more
times than that. I actually didn't want to do music at first, but after I had that door sort of opened for me, mm-hmm. I kind of explored my way through jazz band.
Nice.
And then I picked up the bass at the start of, you know, the pandemic.
Pandemic, which is recently, this year. And so you got the bass right here. You also play the sax as well.
I do. I first started playing alto sax in jazz band. Uh-huh. I believe I started in eighth grade.
Oh, cool. So where did your musical, it's weird asking, but I'm going to ask you anyway. So where did your musical interest, you think it spawned from or derived from?
When I was younger, I would always, you know, sing around with my sisters, and my dad would always be on the sax, and, you know, my mom actually would encourage my sisters to go into dance or color guard, so that's kind of where everything kind of just molded together for me.
Yeah, because their mom, she was also in color guard in her dance troupe for her high school, and yeah, I was on the sax, and it's funny, I can say this, I've seen you grow, I was pushing you to sports. I was pushing you to this different other things, you know, and of course always put you to music, had you all around in music and production as we've been doing in a long time, but I've seen you grow, not just from someone that likes music and want to be around it and try it, I've seen you come into a more concise and precise person where you want to produce it, you also write music.
Yes, I do.
And you compose music. Talk about that. When did you start doing that, and how did you tell someone from that?
So when I started first composing music was actually when I was with one of my best friends at the time, and we were just fooling around after school, and I was like, hey, let's grab a marimba and start, you know, just like playing and see what we come up with. And we actually came up with like the first, I think, two or three measures of a song. But after that, I went home and I downloaded a website, and I, you know, I just went on the program and I started writing music. And after a few weeks, I had an entire song ready.
And he's not joking, like entire song composed, like, you know, charts, and like it's crazy to see you. For one day, I think you weren't into music in that way. Yeah, maybe sing around the house or as you say with your sisters. It's just. You've taken it to another level. And I'm gonna say this to you, Michael, at your age, you're a much better musician than I am. I'm not saying that just to say, oh, I'm the bomb, you know, and anything or such and so forth, but I know I got training, and what I see in you, your talents, your gifts, and all that you do from the bass to the keyboard to some of the percussion instruments, man, you take it to that next level.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And we want you all to take a look at it as well. And check out themichaelray.com. We're building it, and slow and steady is the race, but we're coming on strong. Anything you'd like to say to the people that may not know you? Kind of talk, you know, who is Michael? Like, what are some things you'd like to do? Other than music.
Other than music, I like to play a lot of video games. I like RPGs. I like actions. I like MOBAs.
RPGs. What is that?
It's like a role playing game. So I'm kind of like reenact the stuff in like maybe like books, manga, anime, stuff like that.
Got it.
Yeah.
Some people don't know like myself, so we got to break it down. Yeah. What else?
I'm also a really big Marvel and DC fan, and that's a deal breaker for some people. But I like both because you know I'm obsessed with superheroes.
Got it. And you were telling me some new superheroes coming out on the platforms. So, Michael, in music, since you do so much, sometimes as a musician you can play so many things and not, we say, focus on one, but you also sing and dance, other than being a musician. Out of those three, those trifecta, dance, singing, or playing an instrument, which do you enjoy the most?
Honestly, I feel like each, you know, art has their own thing that they bring to it. Mm-hmm. Like in dance, you get to use your entire body and, you know, perform and show that emotion. But you can also show that emotion through your voice and how you, you know, portray your words mm-hmm. and your lyrics. And when playing instruments, I feel like you just have to find that connection between you and your instrument. And when you do, it kind of, you know, expresses the music a bit more. So it's kind of just pulling different things. And that's why I kind of like to expose myself to as many arts and as many different things as I can, because I just feel like there's different ways that you can express yourself, and you can't do that in every one.
You're so right. So you still haven't chosen one. What? You can't yeah. really knock it down into one? All right. So you added another one, acting, something that you took on, actually you say through the pandemic recently as well. What do you find that your musical background and training helps you in acting, and if so, how?
So when I was doing my, when I was in the marching band at my school, I was in the front ensemble. So, you know, we're kind of stationary mm-hmm. and we have to, you know, perform, but we can't really use our entire body because, you know, we're stuck in one spot and we can't really move around. So in that way, you kind of have to tell the story that you're like, you know, portraying through your music through your facial expressions.
Got it.
And how you like arc your body in different ways and move around. So I feel like doing that, it kind of helped.
Yeah, it helped you. Okay, understandable. And because that, you're right, because staying in one place, you're kind of confined, and you got to use those expressive. And acting, a lot of facial expression gives you the emotion and the feel of that. Do you? What type of acting have you found you like? Is it from the comedy to the drama to the?
Typically, I'm not one for, you know, the whole drama stuff, mm-hmm. but I do like a little bit of drama, if I'm going to be honest. I prefer more comedic.
Comedic. Okay, cool. So we're gonna wrap this up because I want to hear him do some things, and you want to hear him as well. So go on themichaelray.com,
yes.
And that's all the same handles for all the social media. And thank you, Michael.
Cool. Thank you for having me.
Definitely. We're out. Take care.
So I see the shadows on my face. People have told me I don't look the same. Maybe I'm afraid, but I'm playing rookie. We're the best of the best, with my heart on my chest, so that you can see it too. Yeah.